Hello students, good morning, Sai Ram. Let us continue with the same chapter, chapter number 7, congruence of triangles. And today we will understand congruence of triangles. And in that we will understand corresponding parts of congruent triangles. And exercise 7.1, question number 3 I'll explain you. Question number 4 will be your homework. Now, congruence of triangles. In the previous session, we have learned two line segments are congruent where one of them is a copy of the other. And then we have learned two angles are congruent when they are copies of each other. That means their measures are same. Similarly, two triangles are also congruent if they are copies of each other. And when superposed, they cover each other exactly. So let us see how. Now let us see this example. Let's suppose these are the two triangles which are congruent. This is triangle ABC and this is triangle PQR. And they are congruent. And we know that two triangles are congruent when they have same shape. You can see these two shapes are same and they have same size. Their size also should be same. So here these two triangles are congruent. So now let us rotate this triangle. Let's rotate PQR, triangle PQR, and superimpose triangle ABC and triangle PQR. You can see here these two triangles are placed one over the other. And you can see A and P. It is exactly like it is lying here. So A is corresponding to P. Same with this point, B is corresponding to Q. And C is corresponding to R. So we can say these two triangles are congruent. Now here you can see, so how to write this corresponding A is corresponding. This is the symbol for corresponding. A is corresponding, as just now we have discussed, A is corresponding to P. So it will be written like this, A is corresponding to P. Same way B is corresponding to Q, so it will be written in this way, and C is corresponding to R. And we can write this together also, A, B, C is corresponding to P, Q, R. And similarly you can see the sides are also corresponding to each other. You can see AB. This is AB, which is corresponding to the side PQ. Same way here you see the next side BC is corresponding to QR. And if we take the third side, AC is corresponding to PR of the second triangle. So sides are also corresponding to each other. Even the angles are corresponding. Angle A is corresponding to angle P. Angle Q and angle B are corresponding to each other. Angle C and angle R are corresponding to each other. Thus we write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. We cannot write this way, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle QRP, because then the vertices will change, even the sides will change. We cannot even write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PRQ. We will have to write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. This is because of CPCT. Now what is CPCT? I'll explain you. CPCT is corresponding parts of congruent triangle. That is called CPCT. CPCT theorem tells that if two triangles are congruent to each other, then their corresponding angles, just now we have seen which are the corresponding angles, and the corresponding sides of the triangles are also congruent to each other. Now here let us take another example. Now in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, these two triangles are congruent. And we know if two triangles are congruent, their corresponding sides are equal and their corresponding angles are equal. And even their vertices are also corresponding to each other. Like here, A is corresponding to P, Similarly, B is corresponding to Q and C is corresponding to R. So this way we will write. Then only the corresponding sides are also will be equal and corresponding angles also will be equal. Now see here, the same figure again, it is here drawn triangle ABC and triangle PQR. And we know triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Then corresponding angles are also equal and corresponding sides are also equal. So we'll write in this way, in tabular form also you can write. Corresponding angles, you can write here, angle A is equal to angle P. You can see here it's written. Then next we can write angle B is equal to angle Q. And angle C is equal to angle R. Now corresponding sides, AB, you can see here AB is equal to PQ. BC is equal to QR. And AC is equal to PR. So this way we will write the corresponding angles which are equal and corresponding sides which are equal and the vertices which are corresponding to each other. And we can write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Now let us see, this is another example, whether these two triangles are congruent. This is one triangle and this is another triangle. And we'll have to see whether they are congruent or not. So now we will rotate this triangle and we will keep it in this form, in this position. Let us see how to. Now see, these are the triangles. This is one triangle and this is second triangle. Now we will see whether they are congruent or not. Now here you can see, this angle is 40 degree, this angle is also 40 degree. Now this angle is 30 degree, this angle is 30 degree. And this side is 3 centimeter, this side is also 3 centimeter. Then corresponding angles, if these two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding angles and corresponding sides are equal. So let us write that corresponding angle. Now here first we will take angle M. Angle M is equal to angle Z. You can see here this is 30 degree, this one is also 30 degree. So they are equal. So we'll write angle M is equal to angle Z. Next we will take this angle. Angle N is equal to angle X. Both measure 40 degree. So angle N is equal to angle X. Now similarly, the third angle, angle O, will be equal to angle Y. So these are the corresponding angles which are equal. Now same way, now next one we'll take. Now we'll take the sides. Now MN. MN is 3 centimeter. Here you can see here this ZX is also 3 centimeter. So we'll write MN is equal to ZX or XZ also you can write. Then we will take NO. NO is this side. NO is equal to this side, XY. So NO is equal to XY. Now we'll take the third side. OM is equal to this side, that is YZ. So corresponding sides are equal. And that is possible when the vertices are corresponding to each other. That means M corresponds to Z, this vertex. And N is corresponding to X. And O is corresponding to Y. That's why we got the sides, corresponding sides also equal and corresponding angles also equal. So we will write triangle MNO. In this order we will write, because this is the way you will have to write. Triangle MNO is congruent to triangle ZXY. Now children, we'll go to the third question of exercise 7.1 based on what we have learned. Now the question is, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED, under the correspondence, this is very important, the correspondence is ABC is corresponding to FED. Write all the corresponding congruent parts of the triangle. So first we will write what is given. Given is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED. and this is the correspondence. This also you can write ABC is corresponding to FED, which means A is corresponding to F, B is corresponding to E, C is corresponding to D. That is written here. A corresponds to F, B corresponds to E, and C corresponds to D. Now, based on this, we can draw the triangle. We will have to draw the triangle because we have to write the corresponding congruent parts of the triangle. So, the triangle, first triangle will be ABC. You can see here, ABC. So, we will draw the triangle ABC. Now, second triangle will be FED. This is the way you will name it. So, this one will be F because A should correspond F. And B should correspond this vertex, E. And C should correspond this, D. So, here you will name the triangle as FED. Now, we can write the angles which are corresponding to each other here. These two triangle you can see here. Angle A is corresponding to angle F. That is written here. Angle B is corresponding to angle E. You can see here angle B and angle E. Angle C is corresponding to angle D. Even the segments are corresponding to each other. AB, segment AB is corresponding to FE. BC is corresponding to ED, segment ED. And CA is corresponding to DF. So this way we will write down all the congruent parts of the triangle. These are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangle. These two triangles are congruent and these are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles. Now, by CPCT we have learned when the triangles are congruent, the corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are also equal. So here we will write angle A is equal to angle F, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle D. So that is written here. Similarly, corresponding sides are also equal. So AB is equal to FE, BC is equal to ED, and AC is equal to FD, which is written here. So this way we can find out the corresponding angles and they are equal here, because the triangles are congruent. Now children, this is question number 4 based on what we have learned today. If triangle DF is congruent to triangle BCA, this is your homework. So you just see the name of the triangle. DEF is congruent to triangle BCA. So write the parts of triangle BCA that correspond to angle E, side EF, angle F, and side DF. So the way we have done question number 3, same way you will do question number 4. And you have to draw the figure, then only you will understand which angle is corresponding to angle E, which side is corresponding to side EF, which angle is corresponding to angle F, and which side is corresponding to side DF. This is your homework. And now, this is very important. I am reminding you, exercise questions, you will draw the figures and write the solution in your maths classwork notebook. If there is any figure, you will have to draw it in your notebook. And here there is no figure in the question. So you will have to draw it to find out the corresponding angles and the corresponding sides. Thank you. That's all for today.